I am so sorry. I had a few technical issues, but I'm good now. We are ready to go, and it's prayer time. And today we'll be praying. We are going to be asking God to project manage our lives. We are going to be asking the Lord to project manage our life. In the last week, we've been looking at what next. You know, we talked about building, and so we had asked what next. And we said that whatever we wanted to do next, we must have a vision, we must have an action plan, we must look at our building materials, and we must be careful about how we build, that we need to take care. So today we are going to pray. We are going to call on God. Believe me, when you look at your life, I'm sure that you will see that life could be better. Life could be better. Your life could be better. And if your life could be better, it means that there are some things that should be done to make it better. The question we want to ask today is, what is your life's project? What do you perceive your life project to be? What is your life project? And if that is the question, then who is your project manager? Who is your project manager? We are going to be praying in a little while, but so that I lay a foundation for you and you fully understand how our prayers are going to go today. A few years ago, we had to do some work on a church building. And I'm not an architect. I'm not a builder. I'm not a contractor. I'm a lawyer by profession. So what did we do? We had a project manager. That person was on site all the time. That is what he did for a living. So he was there with the contractors, and he took care of everything. So all we needed to do was to come in and say, okay, this looks good, this looks good. We want this kind of material, we want that kind of material, we want this kind of finishing, we want that kind of finishing. But he project managed the entire project. And so we had very little headache. Who is your project manager? Because we have established that you must have a vision for your life, and that you must have action plans, and that you must be careful what building materials are used, and you must take care how you build. But believe me, there's an easy way out to all of this. We looked at Genesis 15 when we were looking at all of this, when God talked with Abraham. So our first prayer today is, Father, thank you for bringing me this far. Thank you, Lord, for keeping me alive. It's because you are alive that we can even talk about inviting God to project manage your life. If you were not alive, that would be a non-issue. So first, thank God that your life is actually a project that needs management, that you are alive. Father, Lord, we want to appreciate and say thank you for keeping us and preserving our lives up to this moment. We want to thank you, O God of heaven, for your love and your kindness. Thank you, Father, because all the good things that you have prepared are now possible because I'm still standing, I'm still alive. Go ahead and appreciate the Lord and bless him and thank him. Thank God for the gift of life. Thank God for the gift of life, because that gift of life is available to you. Something new is about to start in your life today. Father, Lord, we give you thanks. We bless your holy name. We appreciate you. Thank you, Lord God, for life. Thank you, O God of heaven, for preservation. Thank you, Lord God, for the hope of a future. Our Father and our God, we honor you. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Your next question is, what is your life's project? Lord, what is the project of my life? What are you trying to build in my life? Whatever your plan is, O God of heaven, establish it. Establish your plan for my life, Lord God. Father, I surrender my life to you. Establish your plan for my life. I don't want what I think to be. I'm not depending on my own thoughts, on my own plans, on my own. I'm depending on you, Lord, because your thoughts are good. Your thoughts are of peace. Your thoughts, your plan is perfect. Your plan has no blemish, no shadow. So, Father, Lord, your plan for my life is the plan I want. Lord, I surrender my life to you today. I don't want to run it anymore. I hand over the project management of my life to you. Lord, I want you from this moment to become my project manager. I want you from this moment, Lord, to become my project consultant. I want you from this moment, my Father, to become my project builder. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I hand everything over to you. Lord, I want you from now to be my project manager. Day by day, week by week, month by month, year by year, until your perfect will, your perfect plan for my life is fully executed and accomplished. Lord, become my project manager. Father, Lord, we thank you. In Jesus' most precious name, we have prayed. Organizations pay a lot of money to project managers. They have a vision of what they want, but in terms of executing it, of bringing it to actuality, they hire a project manager to run the project. That project manager will tell them when things need to be done so that everything is done properly and in order. No matter how beautiful the vision you have is, no matter how wonderful the plan that you have set down is, unless there is somebody who is knowledgeable project managing it, it may all scatter. You may end up with something that you really did not want. So we want to ask God. We want to ask God, the omniscient, the omnipresent, the omnipotent, who knows the end from the beginning. Lord, the vision you have planted in my heart, the plans that you have given to me, Lord, please come and project manage it all. From the start to the finish, project manage it all, oh God, project manage it. Don't let me be like Abraham, who had a vision, who you showed the stars of the sky and how many his descendants will be, who you told gave a plan and he knew that it was through Sarah that his seed would be named. And yet, because, Lord, he did not hand over the project management to you, he went out and he did some other things trying to fulfill that vision through Hagar, and Ishmael came. My Father, I don't want any distraction. Lord, I don't want any deviation from your plan. I don't want, Lord God, any shadow, Lord God, of the vision that you have given to me. I hand over the management to you, Lord. Project manage everything, my Father. This vision, oh God of heaven. This plan, oh God of heaven. Project manage it yourself, my Father. Go ahead and talk to the Lord. I hand over my life to you for your project management. Thank you, everlasting King of Glory, because when I invite you, Lord, you say that you will come in and you will do what you need to do. So, Lord, come and project manage. Come and project manage, Lord God, my home. Project manage my marriage. Project manage my relationships. Project manage my career. Project manage my finances. Project manage my work with you, oh God. I ask you, my Father, to become my project manager. Father, Lord, I hand everything over to you. Lord, because I want your best to be accomplished in my life. Father, Lord, I bless you. I honor you. In Jesus' most precious name, we have prayed. You need God to project manage. And who is our project manager? Our project manager is the Holy Spirit. That is why when Jesus was living, he said, "Wait until I send you the Holy Spirit." He said the Holy Spirit will come with power. The Holy Spirit will come with fire. But remember what else he said. He said the Holy Spirit will teach you all things, will tell you what you need to do. So now we are going to ask, Holy Spirit, you are our appointed project manager. We surrender it all. Holy Spirit, come and take control. Holy Spirit, come and do your work. Holy Spirit, come and lead, come and guide, come and project manage. The Holy Spirit knows exactly what you need to say, when you need to say it. The Holy Spirit knows when you are going for that interview, what they are going to ask you. He knows what you need to wear. He needs how you will walk in. He knows how you, what is things that you will say that will flood them completely. He knows what you need to put in that resume. He knows the exact word that you need to put in, apart from all the technical garbage that software gives you to put in. Holy Spirit, He knows it all. Holy Spirit, be my project manager. Oh God, project manage me. Project manage me. I'm not depending on the project management of my wisdom. I'm not depending on the project management of men. God, I am depending on your project management. I'm depending, oh God, on your project management. Lord, project manage me. Project manage me, oh God. Makata kashikele prohiboho, manda kuraka shanda la bahebaha, kale prohibo koshele prohibaha. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Exodus 36, verse 1. Exodus 36, verse 1. A beautiful, glorious temple, never, nothing like that ever before built, was going to be built for God. All the materials were ready. All the gold, the silver, the bronze. The building plan was already ready. God told them exactly what that building plan was going to look like. He told them how many pillars, what the length was, what the width was. The plan was set. The materials were there. The children of Israel were mobilized to begin to build. But they needed a project manager. This was God's project. It was God's project. David had already put down all the materials. Solomon added to it. God gave David the plan. David handed the plan to Solomon and said, "This is the plan of the temple of the Lord." But listen to this. Listen to this. Exodus 36, verse 2. Then Moses called Bezalel and Oholiab and every skillful person in whom the Lord had put skill, everyone whose heart was tear to come to the work to perform it. Bezalel and Oholiab were specially endowed with wisdom and skill by God to project manage that temple. The plan was there. The picture was there. The materials were there. You have a vision. God gave you a vision. We talked about building materials. Now you want to ask God the execution of the vision of your life, that God Himself will project manage it now by His Holy Spirit. Lord, as you equipped Bezalel and Oholiab, as you put in them your wisdom, as you put in them the skill, as you put in them the know-how, as you directed them every step of the way, every step of the way, as you gave them instructions, as you gave them direction, every step of the way, Lord, come and project manage my life too. I am your temple. Your word says I am the temple of the Holy Spirit. Project manage my life, oh God, the same way you did your temple. Lord, through Oholiab and Bezalel, Lord, you did not leave them with just the plan to do, to interpret the plan the way they wanted. You yourself project manage them. Father, Lord, project manage me. Kandaraba shando roboko robo shekele poroboho. Ikre hibaka shakra hibaka shalaba karibaha. Father, project manage me. Now Bezalel and Aholiab and every skillful person in whom the Lord put skill and understanding to know how to perform, to know how, to know what to do, to know when to do, how to perform all the work, not some of it, step by step, stage by stage, every single part of the world. Work in the construction of the sanctuary shall perform in accordance with all the Lord had commanded. These people were projects managed by God to do it exactly the way God wanted it done. Hey, Marebo Shtekeriba, projects manage my life, oh God. Projects manage my life. Take absolute charge every step of the way. Lord, you have already put down glorious materials. You have already given a beautiful vision. Now, Lord God, you have already given an action plan. Now, Lord, I hand over the project management to you. Father, thank you, Lord, because I believe it is done. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Remember, when God project manages your life, it is stress-free. Sometimes you don't even understand what is going on, but because he's the project manager, you will be stress-free. You will be stress-free. Believe me, when that project manager was handling the building of the church, there were weeks I didn't even go there because I knew he knew what he was doing. I didn't need to worry myself. I could go on and do other things. Your life is about to take a stress-free turn. It's about to be stress-free. Your life is about to be stress-free. Because all the stress is being taken over by your project manager. Hallelujah. Marebo Shandalabahe. No more stress for me, oh God. You are my project manager. I hand it over. Take the stress, Lord God. I give it to you. You are my project manager. You are the expert. You are the consultant. You are the one who knows every step, who knows every turn, who knows everything that needs to be done. I hand it all over to you. I receive your peace. I receive your rest. I receive stress-free living, oh God, in the name of Jesus. He's building that relationship. He's building that career. He's building your health. He's building your future. The project manager has stepped into your matter. He knows exactly what needs to be done. Your life from now, stress-free. Father, thank you. I thank you for every single one of these, your children, who have invited you to project manage their life. Lord, take absolute control right now. Every step, every turn, everything, take it over. By your Spirit, Lord, direct the construction of their lives. Let stress be gone right now. Let bodies be lifted off. You don't need to carry that burden anymore. It is not yours to carry. I take it off. Rebo Shandarabaka Shindalabahi. I remove that burden from you right now. Maraba Shtakuraba, that person who is listening to me and you are weighted down, you are crushed. You feel crushed by the weight of the stress and the burden you are carrying. Kamba Shandelebo, I remove that burden off you right now. You can actually feel a weight lifting off you. You can actually feel that weight lifting off you. It is the power of the Holy Ghost that is working in you right now. Father, we thank you. Let your children have amazing testimonies of how the master builder is also their project manager. Father, we thank you and we honor you. In Jesus' most precious name, amen and amen. God bless you real good. God is working in your life and in your situation. And I, like always, you can just send me an inboxed message. Let me hear your testimony. I'm praying for you. Have a wonderful, wonderful week. It's Fumi Obilano. Reflections.